welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. You have found a channel dedicated to all things WordPress. It is WordPress Wednesday. And just like us being dedicated to WordPress, so is Pressable, who is our newest YouTube channel sponsor. They are all things WordPress hosting and support. If you're looking for a really great solution, if you have questions about plugins or hacks or optimization tricks, anything like that, reach out to Pressable, check out their support plans, all their hosting packages. Really, really dynamic, great solutions for you. I'll put the link to them in the description box below. You guys, I'm so excited to say that this is my 4-year anniversary of my YouTube channel. That's insane to me. I love it. So in celebration of 4 years of you guys hanging out with me and our community growing here online, I have launched a brand new website called askkori.com. I'll put the link to that in the description box below as well. Y'all, all of my videos live here totally for free for you to come in and dig through all sorts of information, some bio stuff in there. We're getting personal. You get to see some Instagram stuff. Come check it out. Let me know what you think about the crazy new website and be sure to ask your questions to me so that I can make a video just for you. Okay, so you're here probably because you want to know about Yoast. This is what we're going to do. We're going to talk about importing and exporting, how to do it quickly and easily. Without frustration, there's a simple way to get it done, and I did it today, so I know it works perfectly, and this is all done within the free version of Yoast. So how do you import, export, or export, import the settings on Yoast from an old website to a new website that has the same content on it? How do you do that? Well, that's exactly what I did today at askkori.com. So I'll show you. You're going to go into the dashboard of your website, you're going to go over to the SEO tab, and you're going to go into the tools section, okay? Now, this where you want to be right now is the old website. So while that's still live somewhere, you want to go to the old website where the old content was, where you have all of your amazing green lights, you have all your meta description in place, your title tags in place, everything's ready to go because you've already been working on pages and posts over there. And you want to grab all that content and get it ready to go put on the new website where all that content now resides, right? Maybe you've migrated a website. So you're gonna come here to the screen, you're gonna click import, export. Remember, this is the old website, so we're gonna export this content. And all you're simply gonna do is click this button. That's it, not tricky at all. And just in a matter of minutes, it's going to create this downloaded zip file. So this would live inside your downloads folder now. And it's a zipped file. That's all you need. Then you're gonna run right back over to your brand new website and go to SEO and go to tools. And you're gonna do import, that's it. You're gonna choose the file right here and import that zipped file. Click import. That's all you do, and it works perfectly and seamlessly within a couple of minutes. Now, if there's any speed bumps that you hit, it might be the alert that I received today as well. So when I went to go migrate my website over, my Yoast plugin did not come over with me, but for some reason inside the database and inside of FTP, it did carry over the plugin. So that folder still lived there, but it carried over no content. So what you have to do in that scenario is access your FTP, go to your server. And I'll put step-by-step instructions for this in the description box below so you can just go boom, 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 step-by-step. If Pressable is your hosting company, GoDaddy, WP Engine, whoever it might be, go to them and ask for an FTP user. You're going to log in your FTP account, and you're going to drill down into the folder that is plugins, and you're going to find WordPress SEO, and I want you to delete it. Now remember, we're doing this with everybody having a backup in place of both websites, right? We already know Updraft Plus is the plugin we're using for backing up your website. But if you delete that folder on the new website, it allows you to then go reinstall it just like you normally would inside of your dashboard. So you'd go back to your plugins area, and you just say add new plugin, and you go ahead and install Yoast now once you've deleted that folder, and it'll work perfectly. This little alert will not happen anymore because you will have removed the folder that they're claiming already exists. Once you reinstall it, that's it. All you have to do from there is go import your new content, and you're up and running. Hey, if you guys use Yoast on a consistent basis, I've got an entire playlist dedicated to Yoast. I'll put the link to this in the description box below so you can check out those videos too. Subscribe to my channel because every Wednesday I'm releasing a video just like this to help improve your online marketing inside the world of WordPress. I'll see y'all next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, everyone.